So are you tired of being held hostage by the motion draw board of your eBay K40 laser? Well, I was too. I wanted to use the light burn, and how did I go about doing this? Well, I tell you what, let's jump into this together and I'll share the solution with you. Welcome to this episode of DIY3DTech.com. This episode, I want to share with you how I've modified this particular eBay K40 laser on the cheap, so I can use the LightBurn software that I just really love. LightBurn, it's a super easy to use workflow, and I wanted to be able to do it with my eBay K40 laser. I use it all the time on my Auteur laser over there, and I wanted to be able to just switch over, do my thing over here with it, and make my life easier. However, the problem is it's not compatible with the Motion Draw board, so I needed a solution. Now, in the past, about 2 years ago, I modified my other 35-watt eBay K40 laser with one of these, basically an Arduino and a CNC shield. Now, this was a bit of a pain because I had to compile Gerbil, I had to flash down here, I had to set micro stampings, I had to decode a bunch of pins to control the laser, I had to come up with an extra circuit, yada, yada, yada. Fast forward today, we got this guy. So I picked this up on the cheap from Amazon. This is a dual-purpose Gerbil controller also, but it's an integrated controller. If you can see, it's one board inside of here instead of the Arduino and daughter board and drivers. This, again, is integrated into one unit. It also uses the laser version of Gerbil 2, so it can do either CNC or laser, which is great. It also works on 24 volts, which is really important when being used with this particular device, because a lot of the cheaper boards that I've been working with only use 12 volts. And so this is a 24 volt output, so this matches perfectly. So pretty much what I did is I took 24 volts out of the power supply down here, brought it into this connector to power this. The stepper motors are basically plug and play compatible. Uses a mini USB, which is kind of strange, not a micro USB, I'm pretty sure it's a mini USB. Again, over here, it's got the limit switches. Now, one of the things, in full disclosure up front, I'm having a little bit of trouble with the limit switches. In the past, even with this guy, I had problems with Gerbil and the limit switches. So one of the things that I do is I actually don't use the limit switches. I just manually home it, and I use a D28 macro to set the home position. So when I'm done, I just hit that macro key in LightBurn, and it returns home. If anybody out there's had any luck with the limit switches, I've got, I think it's $22=1. And when I do the question mark, it does return the switches working. So when I activate the switches, it shows active. When I don't activate the switches, it doesn't. I don't know if it's because I don't have a Z axis. And I tried cheating with a Z axis here with a stub connector, and it still doesn't seem to work. So I really don't know, but anyways, the G28 macro has been my workaround for this. Otherwise than that, this thing really works great. I love it because it works with LightBurn. Now, the other great thing about this is because of the pulse width modulation output, it's pretty straightforward here. And I'll do some overlays as I've been talking about this. Works very well. I feed it basically into a logic inverter circuit, which is, if I can get it here, it's kind of caught in all the wires. So basically, it's just the same circuit that I built a couple years ago, a transistor and a resistor to invert the logic, because one of the pieces with this is it fires on a low signal, which is crazy. Only the Chinese would come up with that. And Gerbil works on firing on a high signal. So basically, what you need to do is invert those signals. Now, the interesting thing is you can use the pulse width modulation output to actually fire the laser and control the intensity of the laser. Now, it is limited by the potentiometer, so if you set the potentiometer to 50% and you set this to 50%, you'll get 25%. However, at the end of the day, again, this is super cool for light burn because I can now use percentages in a light burn and have the same functionality like on your Auteur laser with a 40-watt CO2 unit. This board was sub 50 bucks. This whole modification, obviously sub 50 bucks, because again, most of this is simply plug and play. So far I've been really happy with it. I've done a couple of tests. I'm gonna actually mount this up inside the case as well as this inverter circuit. So I've just been messing around, making sure I got everything, and also trying to figure out a little bit The limit switches, I'm not going to waste any more time with those unless somebody's got some comments below and hits me up. I have messed around and just about got the gerbil settings, the dollar sign settings figured out in here to match this, to match the stepping. Once I get all that done, I'll post those out on a resource page on the internet and put a link to it. So if somebody wants to follow along, I also have a link to this down below. Now, I would not classify this as a novice project. This is an intermediate project. This guy I would classify as a little bit more advanced because you need to know how to flash firmware and do micro stepping, switching down here and a bunch of other things. So this guy makes it a lot easier. So price is about the same, but this guy's much easier. But there is still some things you have to kind of figure out back from the power supply and this inverter circuit. So again, not hard. I may put something out there and I may actually do a PCB board for the inverter circuit sometime in the future. Now, the other thing I have to warn you about, the risk is if you interrupt this before it can take the laser pulse from the controller low to the controller, which means high here, what's going to happen is the laser is going to stay on. This is a risk in this conversion because, again, if this doesn't go back low, bringing this high, the laser is going to stay on. So if you abruptly end a cut without ending it through the software, the laser will stay on. So be very, very careful if you make this mod. But outside of that, again, I'm really pleased with Lightburn. It makes it a very easy workflow because you can draw, you can cut, and you can do all the things right inside the software, which is great because 9 times out of 10, when I need to do something, you know, I just need it really quick. It's not greatly involved, so I can just hop onto Lightburn, design it up in Lightburn, hit the button, and it's a done deal. So again, hopefully you found it interesting. You found this inspiring. And, you know, yes, Virginia, you can actually make, you know, this cheap sub-$500 laser a useful tool in your shop. And so with that, hopefully you found it interesting. If you did, hey, give it a big thumbs up. Hit me up in the comments below with any questions or suggestions on the limit switch. What am I doing wrong? I'd love to hear from you guys. Swag Shop's up there. Subscribe over there. And we'll catch you in the next video where we do something else cool. So I'm going to go wrap this up, and we'll catch you later.
Please click like below and subscribe to the channel to keep up to date on all of our projects.